Season 15 picks up with us showing up at the squad room, and you know, Benson's not there, and Captain says, "Where's Benson?" And we say, "Maybe she's just taking a rest," and he says, "Go investigate and go look for her." And Kelly and I go to her apartment to see where she is, and you know, that's where it starts. You know, now the last time you seen her in her apartment with the bad guy. So, you know, that's pretty much where it starts. Anytime you tell somebody there's something behind this door, but you can't see it, well then, of course, you're gonna put them on edge, and especially when it's somebody they love, like Olivia, in danger. But I don't know. I mean, it's a very, very hardcore episode we shot. We'll see how much of it they'll put on TV. We shot it that edgy. And, you know, you just have to stay tuned and see what happens, you know, what goes on, you know, what Olivier has to deal with this guy. He's 10, definitely 10, maybe an 11. He's a problem because he's smart as hell. He's smart as hell. And he enjoys what he's doing. So once he puts his sight on Mariska, she's definitely in danger. Well, Raul is interesting because, you know, for all the years I've been here, we've always had female DAs. And they have a man DA. But I think what Raul brings, he brings a prosecutor with the vibe of a defense attorney. You know, the prosecutors are usually pretty square. They don't, you know, in other words, they always feel like they're backpedaling. We don't have enough. Raul plays the kind of prosecutor that's like, I got this. So he's got that attitude of the defense attorneys who always have, you know, they dress well, they come in and they just destroy the courtroom. Well, Raul's like that. So it's kind of like we feel like we have a fair shake. Now, I'm not saying that just because he's a man. This is just the character that they wrote for him. He's a very slick, fast-talking attorney. So we pretty much trust him to get the convictions. Olivia is a very complex individual to begin with, you know. I mean, her backstory is she's a child of rape. So she's got a lot of demons and lots of things going on. And, you know, she's trying to get a relationship going at this time. So she's really going through a lot of stuff. And, you know, that's not going to make a very good cop. A cop can't come into this bringing luggage. You know, they're going to snap the judgments. They're going to make incorrect decisions. So she's kind of like going through therapy, trying to get her feet back square on the ground for the next few episodes, you know. And I'm pretty sure that's what really happens in real life, you know, especially when somebody goes through an ordeal like she goes through.